We want to talk about the kingdom of God now, and that's all about putting first things first. Jesus teaches us that all of our needs, all of our desires are also on God's agenda. He deeply cares about us, and He cares about our everyday existence, our daily bread. So the best way to live then is to put all of those things second as we place God and His purposes first in our lives. This is communicated in Matthew 6, verse 33. More than anything else, put God's work first and do what He wants. Then the other things will be yours as well. Another translation says, seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be provided to you. I have a metaphor for you. It's like chasing your shadow. As long as you chase it, you will never catch it. But if you turn towards the sun, your shadow will follow you everywhere you go. It's the same with our resources. When we turn our face to God and His ways and His righteousness, money and resources will follow us as we seek to live that kind of life that pleases Him first. In Mark chapter 8, verse 36, it says, what will you gain if you own the whole world, but you actually destroy yourself in the process? Another translation says, what does it benefit you to gain the world, but to lose your life? At what cost does it come? The problem is not that you want to gain the world, that you have ambition, and that you want to be successful. The problem is the cost at which it comes. What will it benefit you if you lose your soul in the process? Let's have a practical look at how it could play out if we then did put God first and His kingdom our first priority. The first thing that we can do is to pray about every big decision that we make in regards to our finances. And then secondly, to seek godly wisdom from the scriptures and also from other mature Christians about those decisions that we've been praying about. And then thirdly, as we live with this desire to honor God, we begin to acknowledge that sometimes we will make mistakes. But when we're eager to repent from them and to turn back to His ways, as soon as we discover our mistakes, that releases kingdom energy and blessing again in our lives. Lastly, we realize that our financial decisions are a huge testimony to our spiritual surrender to Jesus. And that's why we agree with the scripture that God has to be first in our lives. We seek first the kingdom of God and His ways of doing things. And then we know that resources will follow. All these things will follow as we turn our face to the sun and we allow God to provide for the rest of our needs.